put in his pocket.
Charlie, y'all come through here.
Wouldn't rather be anywhere else.
Did y'all line it up?
Yes.
He's right here. They're walking. They're walking grandparents out. It's beautiful. It's packed. When I dismiss, do y'all when we dismiss for the ceremony, do you want grandparents to be escorted out or they'll just stay seated?
No, just like whenever I get, because the grandparents, everybody's too hot.
Yeah.
And they're a little faint.
Okay.
Joey's coming back.
So there's going to be a point where I'm not facing you, correct?
Say it again.
Mm-hmm. There's not going to be a point where I'm not facing you, correct?
Once the ceremony starts, or like once we start doing, you now taking Margaret. Yeah.
Okay. That's what I'm
at, sorry. Yeah. Once you've actually stood up there with her, everybody's be looking at your back until y'all end up turning and face each other.
Yeah.
What? Where's the reception at?
View on 30A.
The view.
It's VUE.
Joseph. Am I going?
Where do I sit at?
In the very front first seat.
Cool.
Okay.
Yeah.
You go in later. Go drop your mom off and you come.
Look at my dad. Sure.
We're having this fun.
Hi.
Am I taking somebody down?
You're just walking behind Harrison.
Walking behind Harrison. Behind him or beside?
Side by side.
Side to side. I'm on his feet, right?
Mm-hmm.
Harrison's coming back.
Oh, feels great now.
It feels so good.
Cool down.
You have to bring some energy now. Okay.
Great job.
Thanks.
You let them go and find their seats?
Yes.
How did we get to, where did we go to the wedding?
We were late, our car got messed up, so that's why we're late.
Hey, hi.
How's it going?
Good to see you.
If y'all go around.
Good luck.
Thank you. I need to fix my
Go.
It's blister.
That's, Kristen's aunt, no?
Sure.
Her dad, that's Kristen's dad's brother.
So, I say this to everybody. Relax and enjoy it.
Yep.
It's going to go by very fast. So, just be clear. Yeah. So you get up there, grab her arm, get close to her. Just act like a sister.
Yep.
You ready?
Yeah. Congrats.
All right.
Let's all stand to our feet. My mic, it's not connected.
Oh, good.
So he's gonna walk over here.
Sure.
Be fun. You may be seated, everyone. Great. Well, who gives away this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
Fantastic. Go ahead. Fantastic. Just like that, guys. Face. You can hold your flowers. Well, everybody, we've come together in the sight of God to witness the joining of this man and this woman in holy matrimony. And on behalf of Harrison, Margaret, and their families, I want to welcome you guys to this incredible celebration. This ceremony demonstrates the inner love and devotion that these two have in their hearts, first towards God, but then also towards each other. And it also testifies the belief that God does lead us to our life's companion. And we know today for sure that God has blessed Harrison and Margaret and has guided them to this exact moment. Their foundation upon God is what makes this event significant. So this marriage does not stand only on the authority of the state or a seal on a wedding certificate, but truly by the power of faith and devotion that all of us have to Jesus Christ. So before I pray, I'm going to read a scripture. This is not something that I picked out. It's not something we just read in every marriage ceremony that we get to be a part of. Harrison sent this to me. And I'm going to read this scripture. We're going to pray this over them today as it's going to be a foundational scripture in the next season of your life. In Isaiah 43, verse 2 says this, "When you pass through waters, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they will not overwhelm you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be burned or scorched, nor will the flame kindle upon you." Let's bow our heads, everybody. Let's pray together. God, we take this moment. We say thank you. Thank you for Jesus. Thank you for this amazing couple. Lord, thank you for this beautiful day that we have to gather to get together today. But God, the most important thing is you. And so God, we thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you towards your love towards every single one of us. And we ask today, God, that you be here today. So pour out your presence. Any person here today that's needing a touch from you, God, would you meet them where they are? And would you bless this ceremony? And Holy Spirit, would you be our honored guest today? In Jesus' name, and everybody said,
amen.
Amen. Well, Harrison and Margaret, you made it, all right? And today is 9 years since you've been dating, and today you're getting married, and this is a special day. And I want to let both of you know that, of course, I'm honored just to be a part of it. But Margaret, I got to tell Harrison this just a moment ago before he walked out, and I want to share the same thing to you, and that's just to relax. Enjoy every moment. Today's going to go by so fast. And I think it's going to be amazing. And I think if there's one piece of advice that any married couple here today would give, it would be something similar to this. And that is just to enjoy every single moment. Take all the photos. I mean, from the beginning to the end, dance the night away. Harrison's got a lot of dance moves. He's ready to break out for everybody tonight. And we really believe that's going to be special. But I also want to say to everybody attending today, one of the bridesmaids said this last night, that you're not just attending a wedding ceremony today. You're not here for a great party afterwards. You're here because you play a part in their life. And I don't know if you guys noticed this, but there's hardly any chairs open in this out here on this beautiful day today. And that's because all these people here love you and encourage you. And so I'm gonna ask everybody here today a question. And if you agree to it, you can say we do. And that is for this couple, from this moment forward, would you encourage them? Would you support them? And would you pray for them? If so, you may answer we do. Thank you so much, everybody. And then I asked a couple loaded question. And they don't know the responses to this yet. So I'm going to share this in front of everybody. But I asked the couple, I said, what are three characteristics you love most about the other person? And Margaret, when I asked Harrison what he loved most about you, here's what he said. I love Margaret because she's devoted in everything she does. She's faithful to God. She's a fearing woman of God. And she's beautiful inside and out. And I want to say in front of everybody here today, you are beautiful inside and out. And if you do exactly what you've done over the past 9 years up to this moment, God's going to bless your marriage in a powerful way. And then Harrison, Margaret also shared a few things that she loves about you as well. And she says, I love Harrison because he's considerate, he's faithful, and he's secure. And I just want to say in front of everybody here today, you're not just a great man. You're not just a great leader. Like so many of your groomsmen said last night, you're a great man of God. And so you continue what you've done up to this moment, and you continue to do it. God's going to bless your marriage in a powerful way. But I don't often do this, but last night, being a part of the rehearsal dinner, some of your closest friends up here said so many great things about you. And I actually wrote down three things that I kept hearing over and over and over amongst your friends, and it was these three words. This is about both of you. It's not about just one of you. That you guys are a role model. That you're both loyal to your friends, and you're both godly. Now, I just want to say in front of everybody here today, that we're all honored to see what God has done in your life separately and what God's going to continue to do in your life from this moment. But you know, marriage is a very special thing. It's created by God. It's not a tradition. It's not a system that man created. This is a covenant relationship that hinges on your ability to consider each other before yourself. You guys know this. You're going to face hard times. You're going to face challenges. And in those times, it's hard to let go of our own wants, our needs, and our desires. But that's exactly what God has called us to do. And Ephesians 5 gives beautiful encouragement to both the groom today and to the bride. And so it's going to give some, just a quick word of encouragement, three simple things that you can do from here. And so first to you, Margaret, in chapter 5 of Ephesians, in verse 22, it says this. Wives, understand and support your husbands in ways that show your support for Christ. The husband provides leadership to his wife the way Christ does to his church, not by domineering, but by cherishing. So just as the church submits to Christ as he exercises such leadership, wives should likewise submit to their husbands. And so out of this passage of scripture, I'm going to encourage you to do three things. Number one is be understanding. That means from this moment forward, do your best to learn and know Harrison's needs and do your best to meet them. The second is be supportive. The way that you support Harrison will reflect on your relationship with Jesus, and supporting Harrison will be a direct representation of your support and your love for Christ. And the third is stay submitted. As Harrison leads and you stay submitted to his leadership, God's going to protect you and cover you just like he does his church. And then Ephesians 5 continues and starts in verse 25. To you, Harrison, it says, husbands, go all out in your love for your wives, exactly as Christ did for the church, a love marked by giving and not getting. Christ's love makes the church whole. His words evoke her beauty. Everything he does and says is designed to bring the best out of her, dressing her in dazzling white silk, radiant with holiness. And that is how husbands ought to love their wives. They're really doing themselves a favor since they're already one in marriage. So Harrison, in front of everybody here today, I'm going to encourage you to do three things as well. Number one is give sacrificially. So Christ is your example, and the way that he laid down his life for all of us is how you're to lay down your life every day for Margaret. The second is give willingly. That means no strings attached. Your love for Margaret should be marked by giving and not getting. And the third is speak affirming. The words you speak to her and about her will actually affect how she feels towards you and how you feel towards her. And you guys, amazing couple, as I've already said, set an amazing example. But I know the ministry that you guys are called to is going to be more meaningful and impactful as you seek God and you continue to put each other's needs before your own. And that's going to bring us to a holy moment. And as you recite your vows today, the power of God is going to go into operation. And we're going to witness a miracle today. And you're going to be united by God and become one in his sight. So first, our declaration of our faith. And so, Harrison, have you accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior? If so, say, I have.
I have.
And then, Margaret, have you accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior? If so, say, I have.
I have.
When a person joins himself to Jesus Christ by faith, according to God's own words and God's own statement, they stand completely new. And if you're a Christian here today, you know that that's a miracle. But today, in the same way, another miracle is going to take place. It's going to join you together as husband and wife. So the same power that joined you with Jesus when you made him your Lord will now join you together as one. And so, Harrison, will you accept Margaret today as a gift from God to help you become more like Jesus Christ? Will you accept her strengths and weaknesses, recognizing that she is made in the image of God? Will you love her because you've chosen to love her and because Christ first loved you? If so, say, I will.
I will.
Awesome. Turn and face each other. I want you all to hold both hands. And Harrison, you can repeat after me. I, Harrison.
I, Harrison.
Realizing my responsibility.
Realize my responsibility.
According to God's word.
According to God's word.
Take you, Margaret.
Take you, Margaret.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Therefore I give you my life.
Therefore I give you my life.
And as God is my witness.
And as God is my witness.
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
Great job, man. All right, Margaret. Will you accept Harrison as a gift from God to help you become more like Jesus Christ? Will you accept his strengths and weaknesses, recognize that he's made the image of God? Will you love him because you've chosen to love him and because Christ first loved you? If so, say, I will.
I will.
All right, Margaret, repeat after me. I, Margaret.
I, Margaret.
Realizing my responsibility.
Realizing my responsibility.
According to God's word.
According to God's word.
Take you, Harrison.
Take you, Harrison.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Therefore I give you my life.
Therefore I give you my life.
And as God is my witness.
And as God is my witness.
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
Great job. May I have the rings, please?
I tied them on there really good. They did not want them to get away.
Yeah, I don't think Harrison wants these to get stuck in the grass. Thank you, sir. Though small in size, these rings are very large in significance. Made of precious metal, they remind us that love is not cheap. It's not common. And I think, Harrison, you completely get this. I've seen Margaret's rings. You completely understand they're not cheap. Okay, and so made in a complete circle, these rings are a constant reminder that this commitment you're making today is unending. So as you wear these rings, may they surface a constant reminder of the promises you're making for your friends and all of your family here today. So Harrison, take her ring, place on her left ring finger, and repeat after me. Margaret, with this ring.
Margaret, with this ring.
I thee wed.
I be wed.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
The Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Every time you see this ring.
Every time you see this ring.
Remember how much I love you.
Remember how much I love you.
Every time I see this ring.
Every time I see this ring.
I'll thank God I'm yours.
I'll thank God that I'm yours.
Great. Mark can do the same. Place on his left ring finger and you can repeat after me. Harrison, with this ring.
Harrison, with this ring.
I thee wed.
I be wed.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
And the Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Every time you see this ring.
Every time you see this ring.
Remember how much I love you.
Remember how much I love you.
Every time I see this ring.
Every time I see this ring.
I'll thank God I'm yours.
I'll thank God I'm yours.
One of the most special things that couples do in, as the first act of being married is they take communion together. And in just a moment, we are going to do that. I'm going to encourage you to pray for the couple. But not only are they going to take communion together, it's also the first thing that Harrison's going to do as a husband today is he's actually going to serve Margaret with communion. And so he'll be serving her the bread and the juice. And so as he does this, he serves Margaret and they take communion together to remember what Jesus did for them. Would you take a moment, pray for the couple? Almost done. Okay. You're doing a great job. All right. So Harrison, you can see on the back, there's two little pieces of bread. Okay, there's one right there. There's one right there. Let's just hold on to this for a second. So what I'll do is I'm going to read, and then you'll hand the piece. You'll pick up the plate, hand her a piece of the bread, then you'll grab your piece, and you'll put the bread back down. Okay. So this is, so you put them right here. You'll pick up the plate, put this piece of bread right here, just like that. I'm going to read the scripture. You'll hold the plate up. You're going to give her a piece of bread. You'll take your piece and put the plate down.
Okay.
So again, the first thing, you're just going to serve her. So this is what 1 Corinthians 11 says. For I received from the Lord, which I also pass on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, this is my body, which is for you. So do this in remembrance of me. Give her a bread. You can take your piece as well. You're going to hold those in your hand. I'm going to pray for you, and we'll take the bread, okay? You'll hold hands. Jesus, we take this moment to say thank you for your body that was broken for us. And God, we thank you for sending Jesus. You didn't have to do it, Lord, but you did. And God, we thank you, Lord, for every lash, every bruise, every beating, your nail-pierced hands, everything that you did, the crown of thorns, all of that, God, you did it for us today. And you did it for Harrison, and you did it for Margaret. And so, God, we praise you today, God, that you took the beating, you took the suffering, and you took the wrath for us today. And so, God, thank you for choosing us and adopting us according to your word, that we're your sons and your daughters today. And so, God, we thank you for your body. In Jesus' name, amen. Take the bread. Go ahead. Go ahead. And then scripture continues. It says, in the same way, after a cup, he took the cup, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and you drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. So you grab your cup, hand it to Margaret. Go ahead and take a sip. Harrison, do the same. And pray for you. Lord, we take this moment and say thank you for your blood. And Lord, we thank you, God, that because of your blood, we enter into a new covenant relationship with you, that we don't have to earn your love, we don't have to earn your forgiveness. God, you freely gave it to us. So God, thank you for this new covenant relationship with full of grace and mercy and love. Thank you that what you did on the cross, God, you tore the veil into. And today, God, we have a real relationship with you. And what people longed for in the Old Testament, we freely have today. So God, thank you for your presence. Thank you for protection over this couple. And God, may this moment, may this communion moment be a moment that marks their life forever. That no matter what they face, no matter what they walk through, God, that the cross is at the center of their marriage. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
All right, make your way back to the front. Beautiful moment. Well, as we conclude this ceremony, I'm going to pray a blessing over you guys out of Deuteronomy 28. So I'd love for everybody, if you want to bow your heads and close your eyes with me. Deuteronomy 28 says, if you listen obediently to the voice of God, your God, and you heartily obey all his commandments, God, your God, will place you on high. And all these blessings will come down on you and spread out beyond you because you've responded to the voice of God. You'll be blessed inside the city and in the country. Your children's children will be blessed. God's blessing will rest on your finances. You'll be blessed in your coming in and your going out. God will make you the head and not the tail. God will defeat every single attack of the enemy, and he will order a blessing on your barns and your workplaces. He'll bless you in the land that God, your God, is giving you. And so, God, we ask today and we pray that you would lavish good things on Harrison and Margaret. God, that you would throw open the doors of heaven and pour out blessings on their life that they cannot contain. God, bless them so they can be a blessing to others. In Jesus' name, and everybody said,
amen.
Amen. Well, guys, you've come before us and before God. You've expressed your desire to be husband and wife. You've shown your love and affection by joining hands. You've made promises of faith and devotion and have sealed these promises by the giving and receiving of rings. And therefore, as a licensed minister of the gospel and upon the authority that's been given to me by the state of Alabama and the word of God, guys, I now pronounce that you are husband and wife. And what God has joined together, let no man separate. I can see y'all just inching closer and closer and closer. And I know you've been waiting for this for 9 years. So Harrison, for the very first time, you may kiss your bride. All right, I want you to grab your flowers and you turn and face the crowd. Everybody, I think this is an incredible moment that I think today, I don't think this deserves a golf clap type of celebration. I think we just witnessed a miracle take place that two people have become one. And so I want to announce you guys for the very first time, because it's my honor and privilege to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Harrison Pyburn. You guys Well, all right, everybody. The special couples, I thank you guys so much for being a part of their night. I would love to invite everybody to the reception at The View. God bless you guys. Safe travels.